Greetings Earthlings, this is a quick inbox review of a new kit from Meng model. This is the Russian ZSU-23-4 Shilka self-propelled anti-aircraft gun. Now, you might have seen that I uploaded a review a few weeks ago of the Hong model version of this vehicle. And we will have a quick look to see how these two compare. But certainly the Meng kit has been very eagerly awaited by modellers of Soviet vehicles, so let's have a quick look inside and see what we get. Well, if we take the lid off this very nice matte varnished box, the first thing we notice is that there's quite a lot in here. You can see just how deep the box is, and it's pretty much full. And it's full of these very nice dark green sprues. They're all individually bagged, and they're in this very nice hard plastic. It's fairly typical Meng plastic. Now, there's a lot of sprues in here. Some of them are fairly obvious, like this is the lower hull tub, and we've got some decals here, some rubber tubing, and some etched brass. A small sprue of transparent parts, the whole top, some black sprues containing the tracks, and a couple of identical sprues here containing wheels and suspension parts and other duplicated parts. And as usual for Meng, a very nice saddle stitched booklet. They certainly put a lot of time and effort into their instructions. This one has a nice four-colour painting guide for several variants. Very nice indeed. So we'll start by looking at the instructions. As I said, it's got a lovely four-colour printed picture on it. Nice saddle stitch booklet. There's a short history of the vehicle here in various languages. That's actually quite interesting. And then we're on to building the vehicle itself. It starts off by assembling the wheels with polycaps here so they can be easily removed for painting. We start off also with some of the details for the driver's compartment, and here are the torsion bars, and they suggest that you fit the tracks at this stage. More details here for the driver's compartment, and once more fitting out the driver's compartment. That's something nice about this kit, it does have a very well detailed driver's compartment. Some etched brass here for some grills, and then we're on to adding the details to the vehicle. Now, something that becomes obvious is that there are four variants that can be built from this kit, and you need to pick out the right parts for those variants. So you'll need to decide really before you start the kit which variant you want to build. Here's where the rubber tubing goes. It's used for the cooling pipes for the machine guns. And again, you need to know which variant you're making so you can open up the relevant holes on the top of the turret. And again, depending on which variant you choose, there are different covers for the magazine chutes. Come on, Jim, get a grip. I mean, how hard can it be? That's better. Right, and then we're on to building the radar. And again, there's different variants for that. There's a very nice clear sprue map and some lovely full-colour painting guides. Now, variant A is the V1 variant. And we've got one here in sort of parade ground colours with white stripes from the May Day parade. A Polish Army variant. And a nice camo variant here that was part of the Shanghai exercises. Next up, the 4M variant. This is one from the 324th Motor Rifle Regiment, one from a certain unit of the East German Army, and this is the most interesting one perhaps. This has this little battlefield radar here rather than the main search radar used for aircraft. And finally, we have the D variant, which is the MZ, with this very nice two-colour green and grey camo. One from a Urals regiment in this sort of brown and green, and finally one is used in Afghanistan in sand and green. And then a quick list of all the paints used. So you get two identical sprues like this, containing the wheels and other parts that are duplicated. These are the road wheels, some torsion bars, some headlamps, the idlers, some other transmission details, the sprockets, and these are the receivers for the guns. And in terms of the wheels themselves, these are the Meng ones. Notice the rather sharp contours there between the segments. These are the Hong wheels. Notice the rather more rounded contours, and also the tyre segments. And these are the real thing. Notice these have the more rounded contours and the tyre segments. So, in my opinion, the Hong wheels are actually slightly more accurate than the Meng ones. Now, the next sprue contains some parts that we'll see also on other sprues because they're duplicated for different variants. This one has these covers here for the ammunition bins, some side parts here that cover the ventilation. This is the exhaust shroud, and here are some of the guns. These are the cooling parts for the guns, and the gun crutch, driver's hatch, and periscopes. And you can see here that the gun barrels and the muzzles are very finely molded, and indeed that level of quality extends to the rest of the barrels. Now, with four variants to build out of this box, we do get quite a lot of almost duplicated parts. This one has much of the same parts but for other variants. This is the radome here. These are different ammunition bin covers, some different gun barrels, a different exhaust shroud. And moving on, we now have some more parts. Some are duplicated, others new details. Another radome here, some more radar parts. The supports for the radome. These are the headlamp shrouds for the front of the vehicle. A very finely molded tow cable. This is the mount for the unditching beam at the back, and these are gun mounts. This is one of the parts on this sprue, and I've singled this one out because of the level of detail that it shows. The sort of ribbon cable here held down with these metal plates looks absolutely excellent. This is the kind of nice detail that's all over this kit. And this sprue holds the fenders here, as well as some parts for the guns. And this is the driver's compartment detail, including the seat here for the driver, and here's the elevating gear for the guns. And on now to another sprue with some large parts on it. This one has this large sort of turret ring assembly here. Now, this has some protuberances along it that are difficult really to mould, and here they're going to need a bit of clean up because they've got our mould seam line running right through them. The sprue also has some hatches for the sides, the final drive covers, some torsion bars, engine deck grills and engine hatches, and some more hatches for the top of the hull and the turret, and some very nice ammunition feed chutes. The feed chutes are beautifully detailed. Here you can see that the actual ammunition feeds themselves are moulded in, so some careful painting here will really make these look excellent. The next sprue has the top of the hull. This is the driver's hatch. It has some side panels for the top hull, and yet another radome. Next up, we have some turret parts. Here's the upper shell and the turret floor. These are where the ammunition bins are. This is the top plate, and you can see here that the mount for the rear radar has been flashed over. That's the turret rear plate ventilation, ammunition feed chutes, a pair of shovels, and a nice unditching beam. And next we have the tracks. These are moulded in a slightly softer black plastic, and they're one-piece links, but they're intended to click together. Now, how well they'll actually hold together once they're clicked, I don't know, but they do look very nice and simple to put together. Close up, you can see that the detail of them is pretty good. There's only these three attachment points, so hopefully cleanup won't be too bad. On the other side, you can see the guide horns here. There's two per track link, and at least they're actually moulded in place, and you don't need to add them. There is a small transparent sprue for this kit. It's very carefully wrapped in this nice sticky cellophane, as well as being put into a plastic bag. And it contains these headlamp lenses, periscopes, the driver's windscreen, and especially this part here, which is for the driver's instrument panel. The idea is that you apply decals to the back of that and then fit it inside another part that isn't clear to give the impression of instruments behind lenses. So something I think that aircraft modellers will already be familiar with, but very welcome to see in the kit like this. And there's a small etch fret. This one contains mostly grills for the engine deck and a few chains that attach to various bits and pieces. It's a modest set, but it looks very nice, and I have to say that from using Meng's etch sets before, generally the brass is very good quality. On the other side of this packet, there is a little length of rubber tubing that's used for the cooling hoses for the guns. And Meng has managed to fit quite a few decals onto quite a small sheet here. You can just make out, I think, the white bought numbers for the various vehicles, along with some national insignia here. This is for the parade ground vehicle for Russia. These are East German and modern Russian. And this is the decal for the inside of the driver's instrument panel. So, how does it compare to the Hong Models kit? Well, I have to say actually that I feel quite sorry for Hong. This was their first kit, and if they'd released it a couple of years ago, it probably would have taken the market by storm. But as it is, they announced it about 2 weeks before Meng announced their Shilka. And inevitably, they've been overshadowed by Meng's kit. In fact, pretty much the moment that my Hong Models review hit YouTube, I got comments along the lines of, why did you even bother? The Meng kit will be so much better. And this from people who'd never even seen the Meng kit. Well, I have to say that, to be honest, they were right. The Meng kit really is better. That's not to say the Hong kit is bad. It's actually a really pretty good kit. I've heard that the fit of parts isn't great, but certainly the detail on it is fairly worthwhile. So it's a shame, and I do hope that Hong are able to come back from this and come out with some more kits, because the more kit manufacturers we have coming out with interesting stuff, the happier I am. So that's it. That's the new Meng Shilka, a very good looking kit indeed. The engineering and detail and general quality of the kit really does look very good indeed, and I think that I'll enjoy building this. So, I hope you've enjoyed the review. And I hope you'll like, comment and subscribe and all the other things that one does on YouTube to make YouTubers happy. So, in the meantime, from me, happy modelling and goodbye.